Hey guys, welcome back. And today we're going to be talking about my trash. Like, trash talking. Okay, well, today I thought, since this bag is almost full, I'm going to go ahead and talk you through the things that I am getting rid of. These are not just empties from beauty products that I've already used up, but also some products that I know I'm never going to use and I wouldn't have an opportunity to give to other people because it's probably not going to work for them anyways. But let's start with, this is my Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. I've had this for a while. I have a backup that I've already opened, same size. This was bought, I think it was 2015, when I did my last VIB purchase, because I've stopped being a VIB after that. There was that November sale, was it November? Yeah, November sale closer to Thanksgiving that I bought this, and they were in a duo pack, and I believe I paid like $30 for two, or $39 for two. Yeah, so I've opened the second one. This lasted me for a long time because I didn't really use it that much. But now I feel like I am using a setting spray every day now because I also am setting the powders that I have on my face with that. So still loving that. I'm still going to continue to repurchase setting sprays. I'm not sure if I'm going to go with Urban Decay or just go straight to Skindinavia, because Skindinavia is the maker of the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray anyway. I haven't found a drugstore alternative that works as well, but then again, I haven't really tried looking, so I probably will do that. If you have any recommendations on drugstore alternatives for this Urban Decay one, please leave them in the comment section down below. I would be more than happy to try that out. Okay. The next thing is the Mario Badescu Glycolic Acid Toner. I bought this here at Mecca. It's cheaper to buy this. I was looking actually at the Pixi Pro Glow, I think is what it's called, the toner that they have, that's a glycolic toner. But that's like for the same size is how much was it? $46. This was $28 here in Australia, and I was like, hell yeah, I'm not gonna buy the Pixi one. I'm just gonna go with this one, and it works just as well. I've finished it up, but I didn't repurchase this because I went ahead and bought the Ordinary's glycolic acid toner solution, which is about the same size but is a fraction of the cost. I think it's like $7. Yeah, so I'm going through that, and I'm liking it so far. But I can't say anything much yet just because I haven't really used it that much. But yeah, if I run out of that, I probably will continue to repurchase that just because it's cheaper and it pretty much does the same job as the more expensive ones anyway. So won't be repurchasing this. Although there's nothing wrong with this, it's just much more expensive than what I'm currently using. Okay, I've got here, I've actually gone through quite a bit of these Simple Sensitive Skin Experts Cleansing Facial Wipes. I've had a few of these in my MTs in the past, but I obviously didn't keep all of them. I just wanted to keep one so that I can show you. These are by far the best wipes that I have ever used. I have not had any issues with stinging my eyes or with drying my skin too much. So I definitely am loving these. I've got one that's open now and four others are as backups, but I'm a little bit concerned about what it does to the environment, so I don't think I will be repurchasing once I've used up all of those five packets, because what I'll probably just do is get myself, because I'm using a cleansing oil anyway, then I'm just gonna go and get a little face towel that I can reuse and just put in the laundry when I need to already clean it. Because yeah, where does all these wipes go? It just goes to the landfill. So I don't think I want to continue doing that. So once I use up all the other five packets that I have that are backups, I'm not going to be repurchasing any more facial wipes. It just doesn't make sense to me to be cluttering the earth much more than I already have. Okay, next thing is the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water and Oil. Now, this is really a good micellar water. I think I have one more use underneath there, but I just can't get it out anymore. Like, no matter how much I try, it just sticks on there, like gets stuck in all of the crevices. But anyways, I did really enjoy this. However, it wasn't something like most micellar water. You just use it and then you don't rinse it off. But this one you have to because of the oil component of it. It just really leaves sort of a residue on your face. But I did like how it cleaned my skin. Now, this was something that I used in a partner with my makeup wipes. And because I won't be purchasing these, I don't really want to use cottons to remove my makeup anyway. So I don't think I will be repurchasing this. I will just be getting cleansing oils or maybe even just regular like olive oil and stuff to melt down my makeup and then use a warm towel to get that off. That's what I used to do when I was living in Dubai, and I don't know why I stopped. Now I'm being so wasteful and negligent of my duties as a person to Mother Earth. So I'm not gonna be repurchasing those ones, even though I did enjoy them and still do actually. Another thing that I have is the Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser Face and Body. I've used this up. It took me a long time to use this up because obviously I just use them twice a day. But I don't know. Now, I heard Caroline Hirons, the goddess of skincare, talk about these and how this actually dries out your skin. Because the second ingredient of this is alcohol, cetyl alcohol propylene, and then propylene glycol, which is supposed to be a humectant. But she said it's better to use CeraVe than Cetaphil, so I probably will go that route. Although right now I'm using a Biore baking soda based cleanser, and I am liking that, so I probably will continue to purchase that one as opposed to this. Okay. I do have one toothpaste here. I have used up a few toothpastes, but this is the first one that I'm putting in here. I use the Sensodyne Daily Care Whitening toothpaste because I've got sensitive teeth and sensitive gums. And I do have an impacted tooth here as well. And I find that if I use other toothpaste, it sort of gets infected often, whereas when I use Sensodyne, it doesn't. And I obviously also gargle with a mouthwash. Okay, now this is the Palmer's Cocoa Butter Formula Stretch Marks Cream. Now I was using this as my primer, just as you would use the Nivea shave cream, I think is what it is, that Nikki Tutorials made famous. Now this was good, but well, especially here in Australia, because the air here in Australia, and particularly here in Sydney, is dry. So it was pretty good, but I don't think I will be repurchasing this. Although we are coming into the winter, so I will be using some sort of like hydrating primer. I do have like samples of the Makeup Forever ones, which I probably will start using for the coming winter. It's just that it left my face smelling so chocolatey. And I also found that while it keeps my skin moisturized, it also helps my makeup to slide off quite easily. So I'm not going to be repurchasing that for that purpose. But will be I always keep purchasing the Palmer's Cocoa Butter Formula lotion because it just really helps my skin to keep hydrated. Okay, now this one is the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunscreen Lotion SPF 50. Now, I won't be repurchasing this. This, I believe, still has a little bit in here, but I have had this for a long time. And from what I understand, SPFs only have a shelf life of 6 months, if I'm not mistaken. And I've had this for like 2 years probably. So I don't know if it's still effective. What I do know is that it started. Now, this is supposed to be like, when it said dry touch, it's supposed to not look make it look greasy, but it made me look really greasy this last few months. So that's when I thought, the texture has changed, the consistency has changed. So I'm thinking this is already off, so I'm just gonna go get rid of that. I've actually started using Sun Defense brand here in Australia, which is recognized by the Australian Cancer Society as an effective barrier for UV rays. So I'm using that, and plus it's a matte finish, which is something that I really like, especially under my makeup. So while I enjoyed this, it's already gone off, so that's going away. Okay, I did finish my quick drying professional brush cleaner sanitizer. Now this is an alcohol based cleaner for spot cleaning your brushes, and I've used it. This is actually a product of a friend of mine, but I can't get it here in Australia. It's he makes it in the Philippines, so I did actually order some Cinema Secrets brush cleaner from Beauty Bay, which I hope will get her sooner rather than later. Okay, I am tossing this Ardell 109 lashes. I've had very good number of uses on this, but now it's starting to like stick together. It's not as nice looking on the eyes as it used to be, so I'm just gonna go and get rid of that. I probably did like maybe 25-30 uses out of this. I got out of that, so that's fine. I've used up some of my ordinary products. One here is the Buffet. Sorry, this is the Hyaluronic Acid 2% B5 solution. I've already used that up. I did really like it. I believe... No, I didn't buy a backup of this. I'm using the Matrixil plus HA version of their sort of hydrating formula. I did like this. They're pretty cheap. You can get this at Meijer, and I think Priceline also sells them here in Australia. So I did really like this. Then I've got the Advanced Retinoid 2%, which I already have a backup of, and I have one bottle that's open. But they renamed it to Grenactive or something, Retinoid 2%. It's the same thing, it's just been renamed. I don't know why, and I don't know when that happened. It just did. But when I purchased my last two, it already had a different name, but this is what it was. And for those of you who are asking, I am 37 years old, so I do need a little bit of age defying or, you know, something to help my skin remain supple. And what retinoid does, it's a derivative of vitamin A, and it really helps to sort of renew that skin and keep it supple. So I have that. Now, I've also used up, I've used this up a long time ago. These has been in my bin for probably the last 2 or 3 months. This is the Nuxe Rev de Miel lip balm. My favorite lip balm of all time. And as you can see, I've really scraped off the bottom there. Probably still the best lip balm. The only thing I don't like about this is that it comes in a pot, and because it does, you have to dip your finger in there, and obviously that's not very hygienic. I know that they might have this in a like lip balm stick version, so I might try that. Right now I'm just using the Lucas Pau Pau ointment, which is obviously famous here in Australia, and I use that to keep my lips hydrated. But definitely gonna repurchase this sometime soon, but not right now, because honestly these are expensive. I could buy like probably 5 of the Lucas Pau Pau ointments for one of these, but when I'm feeling fancy, I will probably do that. Okay, I have used up my NARS Pro Prime eyeshadow base. Thank God. I've had to actually remove the stopper in there because honestly there's so much more product left behind if you just toss it with the stopper. So I did remove that, seeing that done on YouTube, and man, I'm telling you, I probably had another year's worth in here after doing that. Okay, now I've also used up this Chorus Wild Rose Advanced Brightening Sleeping Facial Moisturizer. Yeah, this is pretty good. I will probably try and get this. However, I do honestly find that I can get a lot of my skincare through The Ordinary, which is much cheaper and no fuzz. So I don't know, probably will get a moisturizer cream at some point from another brand, maybe even Kiehl's, just to keep my skin from wrinkling. Okay, now what are these ones? I've got a mascara here. This is the Stretch X Stretch Lash Effect Mascara by Touch and Sol. I did enjoy this. This is a tubing mascara. It's a heck to this one. It's very difficult to remove at the end of the day, but now that I'm using Blink, that's even harder to remove. I did enjoy this. It gave me volume and it gave me length, but I also found that it clumped up my lashes, and I don't really like the spider look. Okay. Used up one of my L'Occitane hand creams. This is their original version. I think this is the Shea Butter one. And it's a small one. It's just the 10 mils one that I got for free. I do have backups of this because my hands, especially with after using hand soap, really dries up. So, yeah. Another one is the Ulla Henriksen Walnut Complexion Scrub. I've used this up. I really did enjoy this. However, the scrubs I find are a little too rough because they're so huge. So I don't think I will be repurchasing this, especially since my Biore one has one those little scrubs that burst when you use them on your skin, and they're like made with baking soda. What else? I've used up one of my Daiso clear glue lash adhesives. I've already got two backups of this. One of them I've already opened up. I did buy the Ardell lash adhesive, and I think that's shit. It always just has, or it doesn't really stick on, so I don't really like it. What else is in here that I've... Well, I have here two Urban Decay single containers, but these aren't really used up. I just depotted them. It was pretty easy, actually. I just depotted them and placed them in one of my MAC palettes, because honestly, they're just chunky and taking up space. And obviously, if I don't have them in a palette, if they're in singles, I don't see them. And if I don't see them, I don't use them. So I've depotted that. Now, the next things that I'm going to show you are things that I didn't finish, but I am already going to put into the trash because honestly, there is no way that anyone else is going to be able to use these. And I also am not comfortable giving them away since I can't really sanitize them. The Revlon Precision lash glue in black. I hate this. Because it's in black, it doesn't show you when it's ready for your lashes to be put on, because you don't know when it's going to get tacky, whereas the clear one starts off white and then transitions into a like an iridescent blue, then it tells you it's ready to be popped onto your lash line. I don't like this, and when you make a mistake, you've got a black line all over your face. Don't like it. This is the ColourPop Happy Hour Shock Cheek, which I was using as a contour color, but I don't know, it just doesn't pick up anything and doesn't really show much on my skin, and I don't really want to give this away anyway. This is the Lorac 3-in-1 waterproof eyeliner pencil. This has completely dried out. This one is a retractable one. I've tried to sharpen them because it actually comes with a sharpener on the other end, but it just doesn't really do anything. So I'm just gonna toss that out because I don't think anyone else will have any kind of use for it. Then this is the eyebrow pencil that I got from the Philippines. This is from Daiso, and there's a lot of product still in there, but it's the wrong shade for me. And I find that it's very waxy, and it just really makes my eyebrow hairs clump together, and it's not a pretty look. I've also got here, I've got the Stila Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner, one of the best eyeliners I have ever tried. This has already gone dry. I can't even make a single line out of it, so I think that's time to go. The NYX Tinted Brow Mascara, I don't like this. It doesn't do anything for my brows. It doesn't actually hold them in place. It doesn't have any fibers, and now the lid has cracked, so when I try to get it out, sometimes this whole thing is left behind. So yeah, that's malfunctioning now. I've got a few lip products here that I'm letting go because they don't work for me. One of them is the Rouge Velvet by Bourjois. I really did like this, but the color is a bit too bright and it's not something that I go for anymore, so I'm letting that go. I've got the Wet n Wild Vamp It Up, which I thought was going to be a dupe for the one that I'm using now, which is the NARS Audacious Lipstick in Ingrid, but this is so much darker and so much goth that I find I can't really use it. Like, how many times am I gonna actually be able to use that? Probably only during Halloween. Then this is the Wet n Wild Megalast Liquid Catsuit in Nude Patootie. And I hate this. This is like concealer on your lips. It's so pale. It's not nude. I don't know who would suit that kind of nude because it really makes you look like you're dead. So definitely not using that. Then I do have the ColourPop Champagne. And again, this one, I wanted to keep this because this was a gift from one of my subscribers. But honestly, this one makes me look sickly as well. It just, yeah, it's just doesn't work on me. I might try and pass it on to one of my friends at work because she is quite pale, so this might work for her. But for me, it just doesn't work. And then the last bits here, I've got a cognac sponge that I used on my face before, and it's all like tattered. I don't know if you can see that. It's all tattered already, so I'm not gonna be using that anymore. We'll be tossing that. And I've got a few sponges here, which with this one I've cut through. They just don't do the job. And this one is a beauty blender, but it's so old and so yucky already. And there's so, I don't know if you can see it, but the holes are like, they're so much bigger now. And I find that a lot of my foundation gets stuck in there. So it's time to let them go. Whew, that's a very long MT's trash talk video, but I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know in the comment section down below what you have finished this month of March. This was something that I have accumulated from the last time that I did an MT's video, which I think was December before I moved to this apartment. So there's a lot of things going on over this one, but like I said, if you know of any cheaper alternatives that are just as good as the Urban Decay all-nighters, please let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you very much for watching and sticking it out with me for this very long video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Bye.